Greetings, and welcome to the Methuen Memorial Music Hall in Methuen, Massachusetts, home of the great organ. I'm Karen Sheehan, one of the trustees of the Music Hall, and it's my pleasure to be here with you in this incredible space, celebrating the 75th anniversary of the acquisition and incorporation of the building as a nonprofit educational and cultural center. This year also marks our 75th summer recital series. Tonight's recital is the sixth in our 15-week series and is our annual Willoughby, Frederick, and Emma Jacobson Watts Memorial Recital. We'd like to thank them for making tonight's performance possible, and we invite you, our viewers from around the globe, to visit our website, mmmh.org, where you can support our mission through the donate link as we share this wonderful performance with you tonight. Tonight's performer is Miss Cathy Meyer. Cathy has been a classical musician for more than 20 years, performing, conducting, teaching, and coaching musicians of all ages. She earned a Bachelor of Music in Organ Performance from the University of North Texas and a Master of Sacred Music from Boston University, where she studied with Peter Stiers. She is a minister of music at South Church in Andover, Massachusetts, and is the director of the One Spirit Foundation, where she finds inspiration on how music can bring people together from all walks of life. She is also inspired by her work with energy and is a certified sound healer and is a Reiki master teacher. She brings a unique perspective to her music, offering that we think about sound in a very prescribed way and how our experience would be enhanced if we explored how the vibrations of sound can benefit ourselves. Her program tonight will include several well-known favorites by famous composers, which she will tell us more about. We hope you enjoy this program. I'll see you again at intermission. And now it is my honor to introduce Miss Cathy Meyer.
Thank you. Good evening. It is such a joy and an honor to be here playing on this beautiful instrument in this beautiful space. I'm so happy to have you here with us tonight, and I would like to thank the board at the Methuen Memorial Music Hall for having me come and play for you this evening. That was Mendelssohn's second sonata in C minor. It was July of 1844 when an English publicist by the name of Charles Coventry approached Mendelssohn, wrote him a letter, and said, "Would you please write a set of organ voluntaries?" Mendelssohn said yes, but after a month of working on them, he thought and he wrote back and he said, "I'm happy to continue writing these works, but I'm not really clear what the precise definition of a voluntary is. Would it be possible to change it from a set of voluntaries to sonatas?" They agreed, and over the next few months, he assembled 24 individual movements, which then he put together into the six sonatas that we now know of as Opus 65. That was the second. The next piece that I'm going to play for you is a favorite of many, Franck's chorale in A minor. It's the third of his chorales. He was born in Belgium, but became, after moving to Paris, he became one of the leading musical figures in France in the 19th century. Now, we don't have a lot of music from him. We only have 12 works because he spent most of his time actually sitting on the organ bench improvising. However, the last three chorales were published a year after his death in 1891, and I think they are fabulous. I hope you enjoy it as much as I do.
Thank you.
I guarantee it's more fun to play than it is to watch and listen. It's such a joy to be here. The next piece that I'm going to play is by Leo Sowerby. I find it very interesting how young he was when he wrote this piece. He traveled in July of 1917 to Michigan, to where his teacher had a summer cottage on the shores of Lake Michigan. His teacher gave him the lot next door, and he spent the summer building himself a cottage there where he would then spend summers for the next 50 years. He took a break so that he could rest his hands from all of his carpentry. And on July 23rd, he sat down and wrote the Carillon, such a beautiful piece. And he used it in a dedication concert for a new organ at the Wellington Congregational Church in Chicago just a few months later. After the intermission, I will play another piece written by a very young composer, Samuel Barber. You probably know him from his Adagio for Strings, very, very famous piece. The piece that I'm going to play, To Longwood Gardens, he actually wrote when he was only 15 years old, which I find shocking. He wrote the piece as a thank you gift, excuse me, to the owners of Longwood Gardens, Mr. and Mrs. Pierre S. DuPont. He sent the score along with a letter to them, thanking them for allowing people to come and listen to concerts on their estate. In the letter, he described the piece. He said that it's meant to show great amounts of peace, that it depicts what a visitor experiences when they're at the gardens. First, they come in. There's so much beauty to take in. They're utterly confused, and so there's a lot of confusion. And then once they collect themselves and calm down a little bit, then they can begin to see all the beauty that's around them, even hear some bird calls. Then he ends the piece, he says, with the visitor after they have completed their visit, and he paints a picture for you as to how they feel and the immense amount of peace that they have within them. So here's Leo Sowerby's Carillon.
Hello again. We hope you're enjoying this wonderful performance by Cathy Meyer. As a trustee of this amazing cultural center, I'm so excited to be sharing one of our summer recitals with you. Growing up here in Massachusetts, just 5 minutes from the music hall, I knew it was special. But as a young singer inspired by its grandeur and its beauty, the historic significance was lost on me till I was older. Originally built by E.F. Walker in Germany for the Boston Music Hall, installed there in 1863, the Great Organ is this country's first concert hall organ. The organ reflects both mid-19th century German and mid-20th century American organ tonal traditions. In 1897, the organ was acquired by Methuen millionaire Edward Searles, who built this hall for it, perhaps the only concert hall specifically built to house an organ like this, the magnificent interior designed by architect Henry Vaughan. After Searles' death, the organ was owned by organ builder E.M. Skinner for about 15 years. Then, in 1946, a group of local citizens acquired and incorporated the hall as a nonprofit educational and cultural center. The following year, Aeolian-Skinner, under the direction of G. Donald Harrison, completed an extensive renovation of the instrument. And today, we're celebrating our 75th anniversary with a renewed commitment to bring classical organ music to the next generation through concerts like this. Since 1947, we've presented an annual summer recital series attracting renowned organists from around the world to a filled hall. Then in 2020, when many concert halls were closed due to COVID, we began live streaming the weekly recitals, sharing performances with music lovers everywhere, becoming the first organ concert series live stream on a regular basis. We're a small nonprofit organization run and staffed by an all-volunteer board of trustees. Our mission? To preserve and share the history, grandeur, and experience of the great organ and the hall through musical performances and community outreach. We are committed to providing musical opportunities to students and inspirational experiences to music lovers of all ages. The hall is still presently closed to live audiences due to the pandemic, impacting our revenue. However, we continue to live stream these recitals because in times of crisis, we know music can comfort, can heal, and bring us joy. As a nonprofit, we rely on the generosity of our sponsors, our patrons, and friends to maintain the organ and provide a venue where talented artists can create world-class performances. I invite you to join me in supporting the hall by visiting our website, mmmh.org, and making an online donation. Help us to continue to provide performances like this and build a classical music bridge into the future. Thank you. And now, let us welcome back the incredible Cathy Meyer.
Thank you.
The next piece that I'm going to play is by composer Fela Sowande. He is a Nigerian composer. He was first trained by his father. Then he traveled to London, where he eventually earned his fellowship diploma from the Royal College of Organists. And then he made his way to the United States, settled in Ohio, and is now buried there. He was also, in addition to being a composer, a band leader, and loved jazz music. He is considered the father of Nigerian art music. I'm going to be playing one of his spirituals, Joshua Fit to Battle. I picked it because it's such a fun piece. I think it's one of his best. However, there are many pieces that he has written that have not been published or are out of print, and so I'm hopeful that one day we will get to experience those as well. Then I will move on to a piece called Lotus, arranged by Alec Wyton. It was first composed by Billy Strayhorn. He joined Duke Ellington's band in 1938. The two became fast friends, loved to make music together. So when he died in 1967, Duke Ellington was very distraught and often spoke about how much he missed his friend. He often closed his concerts by playing Strayhorn's rendition of Lotus Blossom. And so when Duke Ellington died in 1974, his sister Ruth Ellington, who was putting together the funeral, asked the organist at the Cathedral of St. John the Divine, if that was Alec Wyton, if he would improvise on Lotus Blossom. Years later, she went back to Mr. Wyton and asked if he would transcribe his piece, which he did, and this is the piece that I will be playing today. It is called just Lotus because apparently the publisher made a little snafu and left out the second half of the title when the publisher was doing the organ arrangement. Then I will close the program tonight with three pieces by Max Reger. These pieces were not really designed to be played together, although I do think it shows a great contrast of his compositions. The first piece is a short scherzo, and then I will follow it by a toccata and fugue. Again, they were not designed to be played together, but because they start in D minor and then moves to D major, I think it pairs very nicely. So here's the rest of the program.